Hi, my nickname is Chef Tummy, and I love Thai food. I love it so much that I moved to Thailand, and I went on a motorcycle journey, but 6,000 miles, from the top to the bottom and side to side in the country to learn some of the best in regional Thai cooking. The people I met along the way showed me their tips, their family recipes, and the techniques for making authentic Thai food, and I want to share them with you. You can follow along with these videos and learn how to make authentic Thai food in your home kitchen. Please join me in this journey of the amazing flavors of Thai cooking. Hi, I'm Chef Tummy, and welcome to Chef Tummy's Thai Tasting Time. Today I'm going to make a dish with this, which is water spinach. It's called Pak Bung Phai Dang. It's a very common stir-fried dish. It has spinach, garlic, chilies, yellow bean sauce, oyster sauce, and water, and it cooks quite quickly. I make this almost every day for myself because my doctor, nicknamed Dr. Toothpick, because he is so unusually slim, told me I'm too chubby. And so this is part of my daily diet. I'm going to show you how to make it. It only takes about 45 seconds to cook, and it's very simple to prepare, and it's something you can make at the last minute for when your friends come over to your house. Just whip it together in a wok, and away you go. Watch me as I make Pak Bung Phai Dang. So the preparation of this dish only takes a few seconds as well. We're going to use red chilies today to provide a color contrast to that green spinach. I'm going to cut these open a little bit to release some of the flavor inside. Also helps them to not pop open. So if you don't like spice, you could keep them whole just for the look, but I like to pop them open. And remember that the heat, the spice inside of chilies is in these seeds and the membrane inside. So that's where the real power is. And here's garlic, similar to what you have in Europe. It's a large size. There's also a Thai size. It's smaller. It's used in sometimes in stir frying. This one's easier probably for most people in the West to get. So I'm going to cut these into some rough chunks here. This also gives a nice taste in your mouth. This will be crunchy. The beans that we're going to use as well have some water, and some of it is a whole soybean. So that also gives a nice taste in your mouth, a nice crunchiness. And the spinach itself, this here, Pak Bung Phai Dang, has a hollow stem. So if you can get it, it has a nice crunchy feel as well. Mouthfeel, I believe, is what the writers of any cookbook over $100 describe as something that crunches in your mouth. It really does give a wonderful taste. So this is quite easy to prepare. I'm just going to tear these off into rough bite-sized pieces. You can do this ahead of time for when your guests come, and you can have it all ready. I call this a setup in cooking. There, and we give it a nice massage. And take these little ones that flew out. Those are still lovely. There we go. Oh, doesn't that feel good? So now that spinach is ready, I got my garlic ready, got the chilies ready. Now we'll put together the sauce. Unless that falls into the sink. Here we go. The sauce itself, we'll use some water. You could use chicken stock as well, or bouillon, whatever you call it. This is a tablespoon, which is the same as 15 milliliters. So I'm going to put in 1, 2, 3 tablespoons of water, which is the same as 45 milliliters. And here's the oyster sauce. See that? So that's about a tablespoon. I put it in the water first because that makes this oyster sauce easier to dissolve. And then here are these yellow fermented beans I was talking about. You can see some of the whole beans are in this, so that gives it that nice mouth feel, as they say. So we'll just mix this all together. It's all ready to cook. I call this a setup because I can't forget anything. And with that, we'll use vegetable oil to stir fry this quite quickly. It'll only take 35 to 45 seconds depending on how hot your burner is and how thick your wok is. And I do make this in a wok so nothing jumps out. It's just that simple. So now we're ready to cook. I'm going to turn my burner here on high and let the wok heat up. Your wok may vary in size. This one's quite thin, So it'll heat up, oh, in maybe 30 seconds or so. And the way I check to see if it's hot enough is to hold my hand over. 1, 2, 3, 4. If my palm starts feeling too hot, then I know it's ready. Another way to test it is to put in the oil and add a little piece of the garlic. So that is all ready for you to go. If that garlic starts sizzling, that means the rest is ready to go. If the garlic turns black, you've done something horribly wrong, you must start over again. So I'm going to add 3 tablespoons or about 45 milliliters of the oil in there and let that get hot a little bit and let it swirl around in the pan. I've got my setup here, as I mentioned before. I'm going to put in the chilies, put in the garlic, and let those cook a little bit. You notice I did that away from myself so it wouldn't splatter back onto my immaculately clean apron. It's covering my beautiful shirt that my sister gave me. And we'll let this cook a little bit. Already the garlic's starting to brown. So we can cool that down a little bit by adding those greens. And here's the sauce. Give it a final stir. Oyster sauce, water, and yellow bean sauce. And now we'll start moving this around in the pan. And I'm going to keep on flipping it. The wok is the best thing to do this in because all the ingredients won't jump out. Inside those sauces are naturally occurring glutamates, the oyster sauce and the yellow bean sauce, and that's what makes things taste yummy. It's a naturally occurring amino acid that makes all things yummy. It's also present in things like cheeses and cured meats and the like. Different foods have different amounts, but those sauces are already a year old. They've been aged and fermented in the factory, and that's what makes them taste good. And they also remain shelf stable, so you can buy them and keep them in your kitchen pantry for quite a long time without them going bad. They usually have a year or 2 year expiration date on them. So that's something you can have on hand and make this anytime you want to. You'll see the spinach is reduced down by about half, cooked quite well. The garlic is not burned. That is exactly how it's supposed to be. Wow, are we good. It's just that easy. So here I put it on the plate. I put these chilies on top. If you're a Buddhist, this could represent the triple gems of the Buddhist faith. Buddha himself, who was a religious philosopher about 2,500 years ago, his monks or priests and nuns, and his teachings. He gave sermons like Jesus or Muhammad gave sermons. So this looks beautiful. You could make it in much larger quantity as well if you have a bunch of folks coming over. I eat this almost every day because my name is Tummy and I'm on a diet, or Pompuy they call me in Thai, which means fatty or fat boy. So I'm trying to eat more vegetables. Good. Run, don't walk, to the store to get some type of spinach and garlic and chilies and the oyster sauce, and of course the yellow bean sauce and water and oil. Make this immediately. This will change your life. In fact, I'm going to eat the rest of it right now. Thank you for watching.